Michael Rains on Expert Village. Now, as you might have noticed, our containers are almost together. In fact, they're going together right now because I'm going to screw them together. Yep, they just screw together like a water filter because they are water filters. And they seal up nice and tight. And then I'm going to explain all our electrical hookups because you know it runs off 12 volts. Yeah, the same 12 volts as in a car battery. Thus, the car battery. So, we're all screwed in together. Oops, you know what? I almost forgot. We got to fill up our bubbler, our secondary safety device. Remember, our first safety device is the one-way valve. Our secondary safety device is the bubbler. What's neat about the bubbler? You can see the hydrogen bubbling up through there. That's really cool. So put our cap back on. Remember, our cap doesn't stay tight. It's a safety device. If there's an accidental backfire through here, the cap will pop off. It won't backfire through the water and it won't come back into our container. So, with that said, put away our water. Now we're getting ready to get into the electrical. As you remember, it's a 12 volt system. Direct current, alternating current will not work. So now, as you know, we're a parallel system. We go down to our gauges, our voltmeter, our ammeter, and then from there we go to our battery, which is here. But our battery needs a charging system. It's going to die if we just hook it up. It's just going to drain the battery. 30 amps is a lot of current to be pulling on a battery for 10 to 15 or 20 minutes. It's more than what you would use to start the car. So we're going to hook up a charger. No ordinary charger, mind you. It's one of these bad boys. Now, I've already had the hookups on them, and we're just going to put it parallel to our hookups that we have for our cylinders, negative to negative, positive to positive. Listen to that puppy hum. It puts out 10 to 20 amps. It'll keep my battery charged and keep our system going for a nice, smooth experiment all the way through. We won't kill our battery. Our battery gives us our steady current, but the charger keeps the battery charged. So, here we go. Okay, you can see our current's going here. Both cylinders are producing hydrogen, and look, our bubbler is bubbling.